All right, we're going to be talking a little bit about fresh food. When most of us need to get produce to make our meal, we go to the grocery store, head to a local farmer's market. But it turns out you can find almost everything you need for a tasty meal just around you in the community. I'm joined this morning by award-winning, renowned food writer Hank Shaw. And you're right here from Sacramento. You've done so many things, and you like to travel the less beaten path, so to speak. So you've got a new book out. You're doing some food tastings. But tell us what you brought today that people at home could use in their own cooking.
Well, everything around you is, you know, we live in an edible world, and it's sort of what I try to do is try to help people sort of see what's all around them all, you know,
all the time.
All the time.
Yeah. Pine nuts, something that a lot of people are incorporating to salads and entrees, but we can find these just walking down a path.
These are native California pine nuts. They grow in the Sierra foothills, and they're just like every
other
pine.
They're there for the taking.
They're right there. They take a little bit of effort to take out.
Right.
But you know, they are free. The price is right.
How do you just say, okay, I'm going to go get some pine nuts on our next walk? I mean, for somebody like me who's a novice and wouldn't even know where to look.
You kind of have to look up to which is the good pine, and that's the gray pine in our case. It's also called a bull pine. And so it's got these giant pine cones, and you say, oh, it's the one of the giant pine cones. And when they fall down in around September, then you grab the pine cones and you kind of have to fish the nuts out and then crack them. It's a little bit of work, but you know, it's nothing you can't do while watching a football game.
And it tastes fresh. I mean, there's a difference between these and perhaps buying some dried pine nuts at the store. We were talking about yucca flowers, and you were saying I'm a little bit too late for yucca flowers, but there are other flowers that we can benefit from right now.
This is elderflower, and elderflowers grow all over the Sacramento region, and they grow all the way up to the High Sierra. And take an aroma. They're really, really floral and wonderful.
Mm. But yeah, light.
Very, very light.
And they're beautiful.
Aren't
they're
they?
Beautiful little baby flowers.
And
I don't know if you guys can see
you
that.
You can use them as a garnish, or you can use them in to make syrups or ice cream or sorbets. And they're just very, very, very cool. And they give you this pretty yellow flavor.
Very popular right now. These berries, are these elderberries themselves?
Those are manzanita berries.
Okay.
And you know, most people don't think that you can eat manzanita. And you wouldn't want to eat this right away.
Oh, I won't taste it.
Because it's real tannic.
Uh-huh.
But you crush it and look at it. It looks just like a little apple.
It does.
Doesn't
it's
it?
Very cute.
And manzanita means little apple in Spanish. And so you crush it, and then you mix it with water and a little sugar, and it forms like a cider. And if you really want to go a second level, you can ferment it.
All right. And make your own elderberry beer or something. You've got this great book out called Hunt, Gather, Cook, Finding the Forgotten Feast. And you have a big dinner coming up, too.
Tell
us about that.
I do. I'm going to be in Truckee at the Cedar House, Cedar Sport Hotel in Truckee on Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
And the chef is using all of these ingredients that we see here in a wild tasting menu.
Wonderful.
And it's, I mean, what we're doing on the book tour is I'm going to about 35 cities. And each one, the chef is featuring fresh, local, and wild ingredients from that region. And it's, I mean, some of the stuff that we've been having as the tour's been going on has been amazing.
So it's a little bit beyond, it's next level, as you mentioned.
It is. It's
beyond
the new frontier.
The farmer's market. All right. Thanks so much, Hank, for joining
Thanks
us
for
and giving
me.
Us a different taste of our edible world.